chose to be a doctor because my dad's a doctor. I was raised in Cleveland, born in South Africa, and I basically grew up in his office knowing I was going to be a doctor. And he's a good old-fashioned family doctor that people go to or went to for everything. So he did procedures as well as manage their hypertension. But I could never see managing hypertension, but I could see procedures and gain an early love for anatomy, and that's how I became a surgeon. I initially wanted to do plastic surgery in medical school, but felt that general surgery was really the way to become the best trained physician that I could become. So I did general surgery first, and because of the strength of the colorectal surgery department here at the clinic, I almost became a colon surgeon, but then found my roots back to just a much more diverse experience in surgery rather than limited to one area. We're not limited at all to any part of the body or multiple different fields or patient populations. So that interest in really applied anatomy as well as the variety of cases and patient experiences is what drove me back to plastic surgery. My patients are very diverse. We have pediatric patients. We may have a breast cancer patient who really doesn't want my services but is banking on plastic surgery to at least keep her more whole and get her through the experience of having breast cancer easier versus the cosmetic patient who comes in wanting an improvement over an area she's not happy with, usually a she, but very often men as well. And I'm fortunate that the patients who get sent to me are in the hands of extremely good physicians. And that really does help outcome because oftentimes at the clinic, we do take care of very challenging and difficult patients. And really the buck stops with us. We can't send them anywhere else. The first consultation is very important. And people who know me know that I talk a lot and would try to get to those patients and understanding what they're here for, why they're here, how can I help them. Having realistic expectations, again, is a very huge theme throughout cosmetic surgery as well as reconstructive surgery. We both have the same goal, myself, the surgeon, as well as the patient, to get you healed with a good outcome and minimal complications.